friends and learners, welcome to the module. This video is a part of the module Technology in Distance Education, which includes Open Educational Resources, CC Licensing, MOOC, Moodle LMS and SWAM. In this video, we shall specifically deal with Creative Commons licensing. Before we go into understanding CC licensing, we must know that why should one consider licensing at all? Licensing is important so that copyright issues can be avoided, or otherwise it will have serious implications for the users, creators, and institutions. What does copyright mean? Copyright automatically implies that all rights are reserved and that they rest with the author or creators. Hence, anybody who wishes to use the work must seek permission from the authors or creators before doing so. Next, we shall take a look at open licenses and how do they function. There are many licensing systems that one may come across while browsing. A few examples of the licensing systems are given here, which are the Open Content License, GNU Free Documentation License, Open Publication License, etc. These licensing systems exist to help users create more chances of finding freely accessible material. The open licensing systems make it easier for creators to share their work freely on the terms that they be given credit for the same. The licensing systems make sure that even if a work is available as free to use, the authors get credit for their ideas. We shall further deal in detail with the Creative Commons or CC licensing system. There are 6 different combinations of CC licenses that are the outcome of combining 4 different concepts. The concepts are attribution, BY, share alike, SA, non-commercial, NC, non-derivative, ND. The 6 different licenses that are born out of the combinations are CC BY, CC BY SA, CC BY NC, CC BY NC SA, CC BY ND, CC BY NC ND. We shall discuss in detail about these licenses later. Let us now look at the conditions in CC licensing and know more about them. Attribution. It is denoted with BY. This condition makes it mandatory for the users to give credit to the author or creators for their work. Non-commercial. It is denoted by NC. This condition implies that a user can use, copy, distribute, perform or display a work as long as it is done in a non-commercial manner. The user can even modify the work as long as the condition is not combined with the no derivatives clause. No derivatives. It is denoted by ND. By using this clause, the author or creators let the users to copy, distribute, perform or display their work only in the original form. One can say that this is the strictest condition in the CC system. Share alike. It is denoted by SA. The author or the creators let the users to copy, distribute, display, perform or modify their work as long as they do it on the same terms as the author. Now that we have known about the different concepts in the CC system, we shall further go on to discuss the different types of licenses in detail and how they affect the OER. The first one is attribution. It is denoted by CC BY. This is the simplest of all CC licenses as it allows the reuse, revision and remixing of the content which can be done both commercially and non-commercially as long as the author or creator is acknowledged. This license ensures the maximum dissemination of the licensed material. Next, attribution share alike. It is denoted by CC BY SA. In this kind of license, the user is allowed to use, revise or build upon the content as long as the user licenses the new creation under identical terms and also acknowledges the creator. Both the commercial as well as the non-commercial use of the material is allowed. Attribution non-derivative. This is denoted by CC BY ND. This kind of license approves both commercial and non-commercial use of the content as long as the work is passed on without any change and acknowledges the author or creator. Next, attribution non-commercial. It is denoted by CC BY NC. This license will allow the user to reuse, tweak or remix the content if the material acknowledges the creator and is not used commercially. We must note that it is not necessary to license the derivatives from the work under the same terms. Attribution non-commercial share alike. This is denoted by CC BY NC SA. Like all other CC licenses, it is necessary to acknowledge the creator for his work. The CC license demands that the content should be utilized non-commercially and the newly developed content should be licensed under similar terms. The last, attribution, non-commercial, non-derivative. It is denoted by CC, BY, NC, ND. Of all the CC licenses, this has to be the strictest. It allows the user to share the content only if the user acknowledges the creator, uses it in a non-commercial manner, and makes no changes to the original form. You will see in the image given here that how the different licenses allow the content to be open educational resources. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Do watch the next video to know more about MOOC, Moodle LMS, and SWAM. Good luck.